So, I'm Jason Whitlock. That's Marcellus Wiley, that dude.
Yes, sir.
Coming up, we'll tell you what the Kyrie Irving's rant about his future really means.
And Tyreek Hill with Eric Dixon. They both will join us live from Atlanta. Ooh, hope they sober. But we start every day with a Whitlock. So what you got today, big dog?
All right, 2 weeks ago, Bill Belichick broke my heart and put me in a clown suit when he and the Patriots went into Arrowhead Stadium and stomped out my Kansas City Chiefs. I lost 10K, swore off betting against Belichick on that day. That was then, this is now. I've emotionally recovered, and the truth is, I don't see the Patriots beating the Los Angeles Rams. Sunday Super Bowl feels more like more than a season finale. It feels like a series finale. An all-time great TV show is about to air its final episode. Patriots Dynasty is signing off the air Sunday night. Generally speaking, the all-time great TV shows do not stick the ending. They end in a heaping mess with longtime fans dissatisfied and confused. Of course, you remember how The Sopranos ended. HBO just cut to black. We have no idea if Tony choked on a buffalo wing or is still sitting there with Carmella singing Don't Stop Believing. My favorite show, The Wire, ended with a shaky storyline about a fictional serial killer. The final scene of Mad Men featured Don Draper doing yoga and a Coca-Cola commercial. There's only one all-time great show that ended at its highest point, The Shield. Vic Mackey and Shane Vendrell were flawless throughout season 7, and the series finale is the greatest episode of television ever. I just don't see the Patriots dynasty going out like that. The Rams are the better football team from 1 to 53, and Rams coach Sean McVay and defensive coordinator Wade Phillips are the equal of Bill Belichick. In The Wire, it took Omar Little and Brother Muzon teaming up to take out criminal mastermind Stringer Bell. Stringer was too slippery for the cops and Omar on his own. Bill Belichick was too slippery for Andy Reid, and the Chiefs had the same kind of talent advantage over the Patriots as the Rams do this weekend. The Chiefs didn't know how to exploit it. McVay won't have that problem. He's been a better coach than Belichick during the postseason. McVay talked his high-priced, flashy team into mauling the Cowboys in a street fight. He turned the Saints game by faking a punt deep in his own territory. He benched all-pro running back Todd Gurley during the NFC Championship, and Gurley didn't remotely object to the decision. McVay is Luke Skywalker, and he's ready to slay New England's Darth Vader. We all agree the Patriots have been vulnerable. Their defense doesn't have a star. Their offense lacks explosiveness. Tom Brady is showing a bit of his age. His touchdown to TD ratio has dipped this season. I think we're looking at an ending as ugly as The Sopranos. The Rams are going to dominate New England. All right, joining the desk now, former Pro Bowl wide receiver TJ Houshmandzadeh. Marcellus, I'll start with you.
Yeah.
You like my pick of the Rams?
No.
No?
No. And I know they're going to try and pull my L.A. card, but you can't.
Wow.
Because I'm from L.A., and I know how to survive in South Central. So you can't do it, but dang, it's going to be hard walking through these streets.
This is shocking to me. I thought for sure you'd be on the Rams.
Well, I can separate my elements, my heart from my mind and my rooting interest. My rooting interest with the Rams. My heart is with the Rams. But my mind is telling me, man, will we stop betting against Belichick and the Patriots? And one, here's an amazing stat about the Patriots in the Super Bowl. Their 8 appearances, all of them have come down to 8 points or fewer in terms of outcome. You never blow out the Patriots, and the Patriots will never blow you out in the Super Bowl. All 8 are one possession games. So you trying to tell me that the Rams gonna come up in there now and change all of that? I don't see it. The same Rams that had their struggles with the Kansas City Chiefs, and we saw when Belichick finally had time in a couple weeks to see the Chiefs coming, what he was able to do to them in the playoffs. The first half, not a point scored. I'm looking at this as where Belichick's going to have his wrinkle. He's going to force you to go to plan B. He's going to take away your best player. And then he's going to look at you and say, what you going to do now? And if Todd Gurley is having the same kind of issues he had, whether it was physical or mental, in the NFC Championship game, and Jared Goff first time on this stage, those bright lights, can't dim them. Can't turn them down. Sean McVay, first time in this situation. There's an hour pregame festivities. The halftime is longer. There's so many adjustments to make beyond the game of football. I just think the Patriots, their experience, and the way that they're playing right now, they're going to be able to win this game.
Jason, I'm with you. I examine this game, and you go back to, let's go back, technically, my rookie year, February 3rd, 2002, Super Bowl 36. That was Belichick's and Brady's first Super Bowl win against the Rams. They won 20-17. Things are going to come full circle now. That's where their dynasty started. This Sunday, February 3rd, 2019, it's going to end.
Is that a gut feeling or is that a...
When I look at these teams, New England is better at one position, and it's a major position, which is the quarterback position in Tom Brady. The Rams have what you need to slow New England down, pressure up the middle. We don't have to sack Tom Brady. They do not make him feel you, touch him here and there so that he gets a little antsy when he's throwing the ball. You have to press their receivers so that he holds the ball, so that he hitches a couple times. That's what Wade Phillips is going to do anyway. They're not going to blitz. They can get four first-round picks on that D-line.
Yeah.
Michael Brockers, Ndamukong Suh, Aaron Donald, Dante Fowler. They got to go work. Mm-hmm. They're not going to blitz. They're going to get pressure up the middle, and that's going to get Tom Brady off his mark.
Who's the best offensive lineman on New England? I'll give you a hint. It's Tom Brady. Oh, that's the answer. You know why? 2.5 seconds or fewer, he's going to throw the ball. Quickest release in the league.
It's easy to get rid of the ball in 2.5 seconds when the corners are playing off coverage. But when I get in your face, now you got to beat me off the line. Now get into your route. It ain't that easy.
Marcus Peters, you going to put him in press man? We want to see that. Marcus Peters wants that. That's not what he's built for.
Huh? It doesn't have to be all the time. Okay. Enough time.
Well, we saw him when he did it enough times earlier in the season. That wasn't
against
good
who, though?
New Orleans? New Orleans?
Against who?
Oh, you talking about Thomas? Michael Thomas?
Are you
trying to say Julian Edelman in the phone booth can't expose Marcus Peters? Yes.
Julian Edelman can.
Yeah.
But we cannot let Julian Edelman and Gronkowski beat us. What they do to Michael Thomas when they played the Saints, as you told me?
Yeah.
Put him on a milk carton.
They did.
And so you think they going to let Julian Edelman win this game? No.
Okay, then James White leaks out the backfield. That's the problem. See, if you want to play press man, then you're going to expose Marcus Peters to a degree. You want to play your normal zone, all of a sudden we're going to have the backs out the backfield. Like, pick your poison, and that's going to be the interesting gameplay.
You got to put the ball in Tom Brady's hands. I'd rather Tom Brady throw the ball 45 times and you run the ball for 125, 30 yards. You got to stop the run. Stop the run. You stop the run, you beat New England.
And Marcellus, I think TJ's point, and it's certainly mine, is yes, Brady's release and ability to diagnose the defense allows him to get the ball out quicker than damn near everybody.
Everybody.
But not every time.
Right.
And so it's, again, what do you do those 6 to 8 times when he has to hold the ball? And if you can touch him on 2 or 3 of those, you can get him off his mark. And again, Wade Phillips against Tom Brady in the postseason, I think a 6-4 touchdown to interception ratio, 6 TDs, 5 interceptions.
Right.
I think Tom Brady has thrown enough interceptions. Again, I'm looking at that Chiefs game where he should have thrown 3. You can get him off his square, and Marcus Peters is a specialist at baiting a quarterback into thinking he's got a throw and then jumping in there for the interception. Aqib Talib also. I just think they're going to turn Brady over a couple times. I think they're going to touch Brady a couple times. And again, for the most part, Brady's going to be himself most of the time. When he's not, I think they're going to exploit it.
Man, I need to give myself props for this objective analysis because I am literally saying stuff that I don't really want to happen, but I just see it occurring. One, the best pass rushing defensive line in the league is not the Rams. It was the Chiefs.
Okay, can I say something?
You better interrupt me because you don't want this to start flowing.
Where did they play at?
Arrowhead?
Was it great footing?
No.
You're a D-lineman. No. Is that get-off going to be good in Kansas City like it is in Atlanta?
No, it's not.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, respect. Okay. So we're going to say the situation is obviously going to be neutralized. You're in the dome in this situation.
Let me add
this. Man, y'all know this.
I just want to add this. Kansas City does have the best pass rush, 52 sacks. Think them and the Steelers.
Right.
The Rams have the best pass rush personnel. There's a
individuals.
Difference.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to say this. All right. You want to try to beat up that point? Here's my second point. If you want to look at the last 6 games for the Patriots, you know how many times Tom Brady's been sacked? five times. Like literally five. So that's six, plus you got a bye week. That's 7 weeks. Tom Brady in the last 2 months has been sacked five times. You're not getting to him. When we used to play against Tom Brady, I was in his division, we used to play against Peyton Manning. And we had tremendous defenses, number one defense. We had the best sack artist in the league's history. When we faced those boys, you know what we would say? It's not a move in the world you can use to get to them if they're feeling comfortable with a line that can protect them. And how do they feel comfortable? If the offense is flowing. If you're giving me press coverage, okay, fine. We'll expose the one that can't do it. If you're going to go back and play zone, that's fine. We'll leak out the backfield. They're going to have multiple ways to expose the Rams. Where the Saints didn't fully expose the Rams, I think the Patriots and their genius and their efficiency is going to be able to do
it. It's not about getting sacks. It's not about getting the sacks. It's about making Brady feel that pressure. He feels you. He throws the ball. You touch him.
Yeah. Denver. He smelled, when Denver got out.
That's all you want. Uh-huh. You want him to feel you. And the good thing about the Rams, they don't have to blitz. So you're talking about throwing the ball out the backfield. They always going to have a lurker or a robber in the middle of the field. So that backer that is covering James White, he can shade outside. I'm going to make you go right inside to my help because we're not blitzing. We're going to get home with four. So now I got seven in the back end for coverage. Brady is going to be Brady. My key to this game is the Rams have to stop the run. They cannot run the ball. Make them one-dimensional.
Let me say why I'm really shocked, Marcellus, is because you spent the entire football season telling me about Sean McVay.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, man, I got to see it. I got to see it. I got to see it. Mm-hmm. I've seen it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, this young dude is the next Belichick.
Oh, yeah.
And so you're sitting there talking about what Belichick's going to do. Are you thinking about what Sean McVay is going to do? And then he has Wade Phillips. That combination, I think, is going to be pretty powerful. I think it's going to be the equal of Belichick and Josh McDaniels.
Yeah, I hope you're right. But it's been too many times I bounced into a YMCA and saw the old man with the headband and the socks pulled up. And I'm like looking at that sensei like, I got you, bro. And no, I don't, because he is too efficient with what he does. And they always keep the secret sauce close. No matter what you can learn from somebody else through osmosis, through witnessing, there's always a secret sauce. Grandma knew how to stir it. She could give you the recipe. She just stirred it a different way. Belichick is still out there. You could be the next Belichick, but the Belichick that exists right now hasn't left anywhere. And for us to say that the dynasty is over, how many times are we going to predict their demise and be wrong about it? Nostradamus predicts 1,000 things, gets 2 right. Oh, he's a genius. Oh, he's right. Oh, my God. Confirmation bias. Stop it, y'all. They were in the Super Bowl last year. We predicted their demise. They're in the Super Bowl again this year. We predict their demise. I think they may be in it again next year if Kansas City doesn't come and overthrow.
I mean, that's the thing. There's a lot of good teams in the AFC, young, coming up. The way I see it, it's just almost ironic. February 3rd, 2002, February 3rd, 2019. That's how I see it going.
Oh, again, stop that. What's your sign? We going into Australia. Where we going?
There's a
sign?
Little something to that, man.
Horoscopes. What's next?
I mean, but if you root for the Patriots, you can look at it and say, okay, we won our first one. We gonna win our last one. I mean, you can look at it that way as well. Make the Patriots killed San Diego and killed the Chiefs.
LA, yeah, yeah.
Because San Diego, the Chargers.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they ran the ball. That first drive, they ran the ball. They killed them. Mentally,
yeah.
We're going to punch you in the mouth and we're going to run the ball. You can do nothing about it.
You know why?
You have to stop that run.
You know why they were allowed to run the ball? Because you have Tom Brady in the passing game. And look, it's not full of big names, but it's so potent and efficient, and they have an option route on every route. You know this. Chad was up there for a few seconds, and everybody I know that's played there, they're like, dude, cornerbacks can't cover us. With our chemistry with Tom Brady, the fact that he's going to get the ball out and we can read your coverage and have options per route, it's nothing you can do. You play inside, he's out. You play out, he plays.
But if I'm in your face pressing you, slows you down.
Yes, it does.
It slows you. And those receivers, they're not the – Julian Edelman will get open.
Yeah.
But if I'm not – we're not playing two-man like the Chiefs were playing. We just let Edelman run down the middle because we don't banjo inside.
Yeah.
I'm playing you man-to-man. This is my guy. I got a robber in the middle. Tom Brady got to be perfect. And he might be –
oh, that's hard.
He might be perfect. Hard. But if they don't run the ball – it is not going to matter. It's not going to matter.
All right, stick around.